Hello friends, welcome back. We are going to learn the next set of interview readiness questions from Communication Engineering. I posted my first set of 10 questions long back, and now when I was recollecting everything, I thought that this should be completed. So we are going to go with the next set of 10 questions from Communication Engineering. What is attenuation? When there is a reduction in signal strength, normally when the signal moves on, it gets slowed down, which means there is a loss or reduction in signal strength. That is called as attenuation. I can tell you a simple example. You are walking for a long distance, say about 10 kilometers. First kilometer, you will be brisky. Second kilometer, you will be okay. Third kilometer, you will get tired. This can be called an attenuation. The reason behind this, technically speaking, with respect to signal strength is, the signal is getting transferred through a medium, and the medium will absorb some energy. It is like you walking under the hot sun, and the sun is going to take some energy out of you. In other words, clearly saying again, the amplitude of the signal is reduced, and that's called attenuation. So it is all about reduction of the signal strength. That's it. We are getting the signal strength weakened. Now, the next question. What is path loss? When the distance is large, I mean the distance from the source to destination, and when the wave is traveling through the space for a larger distance, then the signal becomes weak. This is what I told you in the previous question. I walk for a longer distance, the signal travels along a longer distance, it gets slowed down and it gets weaker as it goes further and further and further. This is because of the propagation distance. The distance is large. And once you move on, the line of sight will not be there. Line of sight is something which you can see. If I see you in the straight line, I call it line of sight. If I miss you, it is called I lost the line of sight. Since the line of sight is also not there, it is the reason for this attenuation of the signal, and this is what is referred as path loss. Remember it, it's a very important question. What is meant by white noise or Gaussian noise? A signal having all kind of frequencies is called a white signal. This is otherwise called a Gaussian noise. That's all. The reason for calling it as a white signal is because this noise has got all range of frequencies. When it has all range of frequencies, we can call it white noise or Gaussian noise. Now, what is multiplexing? If you have multiple messages, and among that, only one is to be selected, and if it is transmitted through the path or the channel, I call it multiplexing. I've got 10 people standing in front of me to talk to me. If I select only one person and allow him to come to my cabin, where only one person can only sit and talk to me, I call it multiplexing. What is a carrier? When we transmit data, we add weight to the data so that the data travels for a longer distance. I taught you this in my modulation question. I'm going to push something, some data. The data has to travel to a longer distance, so I add some weight to it. It is like tying stone on the paper and throwing the paper. The stone will take the paper for a longer way. This is done along with the input signal, and when we want to travel short distance, we do not have any problem. But when we want to go for a longer distance, we need to do that. And this addition is a very important thing to look into here. Now, I'll tell you an example again. We are going to walk for a shorter distance. We'll walk. We have no problem. We are going to cover a shorter distance, we can walk. But when we want to go for a longer distance, say about 100 miles, we'll go by train or bus. What is the train or bus there? That is nothing but the carrier signal. That's it. What is OFDM? OFDM is nothing but orthogonal frequency division multiplexing. In this, the carriers are all orthogonal to each other, which help in avoiding interference. It's a very important question. To avoid interference, OFDM is followed because it is orthogonal in structure. What is SNR? SNR is signal to noise ratio, where the noise level should be definitely lesser for the signal to be very good and for the better performance. If I'm talking right now, or my video is presented right now, and if there is a noise, it won't be good, right? So the noise level should be lesser. That's what eventually what is called as signal to noise ratio. Now in science and engineering, when you come to it, this is nothing but the comparison that happens between the desired signal and the background noise. That's it. I have desired signal and I have background noise. So how much is the background noise? How much is the desired signal percentage? That's called signal to noise ratio. It is nothing but the ratio of the signal power to the noise power, right? And most of the times it is called in dB. That is nothing but decibels. Define EDGE. EDGE stands for enhanced data rates for GSM evolution. Remember, this is what is called as mostly 2G, but it is actually 2.5G and 2.75G, even people call it. It is used for packet data services. The maximum speed is 217.6 kbps download and 108.8 kbps upload. Edge is nothing but enhanced data rates for GSM evolution. Now, what is handover? This is a very important interview question. This is a very, very important interview question, in fact. When we make a call through the phone while we are in the vehicle or moving on the road, we get transferred from one base station to another base station as we keep moving on. This is called handover. I can tell you a simple example. When we travel in flight or when you fly in an aeroplane, the aeroplane goes from one air base station to another air base station. It is called one ATS to another ATS it goes. So that is called handover. The handover happens from one base station to another base station, and that ensures the connectivity for you. Now, what is uplink? What is downlink? When the communication happens from the ground to the satellite, we call it uplink. From here to satellite is called as uplink. For example, when we upload a video or send a photo to our friend, we are calling it uploading, right? This can be called uplink. When the communication happens in the reverse way from the satellite to the ground, we call it downlink. When we download the photo which is sent by your friend, we can relate it to downlink. That's all. The learning will evolve. In the next session, we'll have the last 10 questions for communication engineering, which I think will be very useful for you too. Thank you for following the channel consistently. And if you have any questions, suggestions, please go ahead and type it in the comment sections. If you like the channel, please subscribe. You can refer it to your friends as well. Thank you.